Okay, farmers, hopefully this camera's gonna work this time. Probably won't, but whatever. Okay, anyway, welcome back. We're gonna be working on something a little bit more interesting today. Okay, so still having camera problems. Hopefully it's not gonna... I know this is getting to be more of a mechanical working on stuff channel, but if you can see the sky and see the ground, it's wet. Very wet. I know I've been was complaining about it being dry earlier in the year, but it's wet now. So this is almost ready to be cut. I think I'm gonna wait 2 more weeks, do it middle of September, and see. I think I'm gonna buzz it off in the middle of September, just, and I was watching one of the farmer's idiot blocks videos. I don't know, I found them entertaining, really. I like his videos. They're really funny videos. But you can see we got a cleared workspace and some carbon throttle body cleaner here. You'd be wondering what the heck this is for. All right, so we're out here and we're gonna be working on the carburetors on this. Now this is a 1992 Yamaha V6 175 horse boat engine. It's a beast when it runs, but it's I think we got some dirty jets in the carburetor and it's just not running quite right. Also, co-op update. It is back together again. I ended up using the other bearings. Castle nuts on the bottom had backed off just a slight bit and they was making it a little loose in there. But once I tightened them back up to torque, it firmed up and now it's not rattling at all. So, well, I haven't tried to start it because we had to go get oil and we had to order some filters for it. But I will show the startup when we do start it up, because the fair is in 2 weeks and I'm glad I was able to get it back together now and not later. So anyway, I'm gonna take the carburetors into the trailer and we'll start working on it. So I'll see you then. All right, so straight into working on this, these carburetors. I basically call this thing the poor man's Holley Tri-Power. And all you muscle car guys will know what I'm talking about. But basically, I pulled the bowl off here and I found a bunch of gel. Orange gel. Which is kind of weird. It's all like goo. Like,
oh, nice.
And basically, the best way I can describe it is if you took Jell-O and smashed it up with a mashed potato smasher. That's what it looked like in there. And then there was only a little bit of that, and then there was a bunch of ethanol corrosion and some black flakes of dirt, so you can see in there. And so yeah, and the needles weren't, and the I call them jets. I don't know the technical terms, but the two center tubes there between the float, in between the floats, or the two center tubes in the floats, those were all gelled up as well. And I also found some stuff in the bottom of the float bowl and in some other ventries, so cleaned all that out. And here I had to get a bigger screwdriver because the one I had was too small and I still couldn't get the darn things to come out, so I had to go get the, you'll see what I had to do in a minute, but yeah, So I threw those back on later. You'll see me do that. And, so yeah, again, with all the tools. There, I got the channel locks, and those took them right off, basically. I'd use the Chinese vice grips on one because I could get a tight enough grip on it, but pulled them out of, I basically spent another hour and a half or so after I stopped filming just cleaning these things up. And here you'll see the jet that was full of stuff. See, that one's clean there. Or no, that's not the clean one, that's the dirty one. There you see, it's focusing on my hand. You'll have to, there you go. You can see all the stuff that's in there. So yeah, and I plan on trying to start the motor tomorrow. So we'll see what happens. And well, I would love to own the boat that's on the screen right now. I cannot afford it, obviously. Just try writing up a check for $3 million. Of course, as soon as anyway, here I am gonna put a time lapse of putting the carburetors back on the motor. Enjoy.
You can see these things are kind of weird looking. It's a vertical V6. It works well, but when it breaks, it's kind of weird to figure out what's wrong with them. So start time lapse right now. Because this is going to take a little bit. Thank you.